Let's start by creating the basic signet ring shape. And after finishing it, you will already have a fully usable, fully printable model ready to go. Hit 1 on your numpad for front view. Shift A, curve, and circle. Down here on the left, choose align to view and then set the radius that corresponds to your desired ring size. You can basically set it to whatever you want, but if you choose to create the ring for somebody in particular, it might be nice to go with the correct ring size right away. We're now going to create a cube and then slice it so that we can delete 3/4 of it. Shift A, add cube. Tap to edit mode, Ctrl R, and right click to create a new line of vertices in the exact center. Repeat this and then select with left mouse or C and delete the vertices with X which are not needed. To not leave the cube all cut open like that, let's give him the missing parts back. Select the outer vertices and pull them out with G and X along the X axis. Tap to object mode, add a mirror modifier, and this will then mirror the vertices along the selected axes. And voila, the cube is whole again. Tap to edit mode again and use Ctrl R and scrolling your mouse wheel to add a few more segments. Those will enable the cube to bend along the curve. And that's what we're going to do. Tap to object mode, add a curve modifier, and choose our Bezier circle as the target. Ctrl 2 to soften the hard edges with a subdivision modifier. And this will give us our very handy basic ring band. In edit mode, you can pull out the side vertices a little bit more along the Y axis so that you have a broader ring band instead of just an elongated cube. Signet rings are very often getting broader and broader towards the top. This flow of the shape, this progression, can be easily achieved by rotating the vertices on the side. But if we just rotate them like this, the shape looks weird. What could we do then? Exactly! We set the pivot point. For this, select one of the two outer end vertices. Hit Shift S and choose Cursor to select it. Now the 3D cursor jumps to the vertices you selected. To rotate, Alt select, then Shift Alt select the outer rows. And when we hit R and Z to rotate along Z, now this happens. Depending on your settings, it might still look a little bit wrong. To solve this, we need to make the pivot point the center of rotation for our ring band, not the vertex we selected. And this happens up here. Simply select 3D cursor and the rotation will happen around all the right places. Let's continue. To make our surface a bit smoother and to check if we have overall a nice foundation, you can level up the subdivision modifier from 2 to say 3. To give us a little bit more control over the shape, we can add an additional row of verts with Ctrl R and right click for center. We don't need the extra verts inside of the ring band, and we also don't need closed end caps here, since we are going to connect the ring to something, more precisely the top. 3 for face mode, and just select them and delete with X and faces. 2 for edge mode, and we can bring those up a bit as well. Since it really makes some perfect synesthetic organ inside me itch that the 3D cursor isn't exactly in the center anymore, let's finally clean up the scene and hit Shift C to put it back where it belongs. Let's hide our ready-made signet ring for now and create the top of the ring. I am using a circle. Shift A, mesh and circle. This is going to be the upper part. Choose the amount of vertices according to the amount of vertices on the outer part of the ring band. Because we want to connect them later, this makes it easier for us. I choose 16. Numpad 1 for front view. Now you can move the circle to the height your feel makes sense for your ring. I choose 3 mm here. This would take some experimenting and also depends on the usage of your model. If you want to print it later in metal, make it too high and the ring will be very heavy and will keep circling around the finger to the sides. It could also become uncomfortable or impractical. On the other hand, some designs just need something like this to stand out. And of course, you have always the option of making it hollow later on. Now it is time to connect the table and the rest of the ring. First, in edit mode, we will lengthen the basic ring band a bit more to help us with connecting to the upper part. Then, I look at the ring band in subdivided mode, and I see that the subdivision makes it curl in a bit too far into the ring size, making the ring smaller. That is why in edit mode, I lift up the whole thing along the Z-axis a bit to give it some more space. Now it lies exactly on the ring size. Afterwards, we adjust the thickness of the ring band slightly more. As long as the curve modifier is not applied, it is easier to change the thickness and wideness in a comfortable way. In the lower center of the ring, it looks as if the ring is not connected. That is why we need to turn clipping on, so the words stick to each other in the mirror plane. Once you have that, you can adjust the thickness of the ring with R and Y. If you want to see on the fly how your measurements are, go to the measurement tool in object mode and use it like a caliper. Hold shift to stick to things when measuring. If you want to delete some measures, click them and delete. If you want to keep them, just change the mode and they will hide. Once you feel you have some nice proportions, you can then apply the curve modifier. This will give us more comfort when building the rest of the geometry, face by face. Now we are going to join both meshes into one. Turn off mirror mode. Select the circle, tap to edit mode, and delete all words except the ones above the ring quarter. Go back to object mode and then first select the circle, then the ring band, so this is the active object. Join mesh with Ctrl J. Tap to edit mode again, and here you can now see that all vertices are part of this one mesh, and the circle words have inherited all modifiers from the ring band. Neat. Let's connect both parts. Select the words that are directly opposite and hit F to fill faces in. Now here, we can make it easy for us by going to front view with 1, selecting these words that are not yet connected, E for extrude, and then moving them inwards to roughly the same distance as the last segment. Because of the subdivision, you can see that the ring shape stays nice and round and we can put the new words exactly on the ring size circle. Here, you also don't need to hit Shift Y for staying in the X and Z plane. If you are in orthogonal view, meaning the front, side and top view with the numpad keys, the movement will automatically only happen in 2D. Again, extrude, and the words should get pulled towards each other and merged like little points of gravity when getting near the center line because of the mirror modifier clipping setting. I find it always oddly satisfying when this happens. Now we want to adjust the shape a little bit to follow the overall style of the ring. To make it look a bit smoother, let's turn on proportional editing up here and also check connected only, connected words only. This is most often the setting you want. You can also just hit O to turn it on. Now we can close the ring up. This face sits a bit awkwardly between the others, but because it still is a quad, it does not make the surface jagged or weird when subdividing. And this is what I mean by edge flow. In face mode, if you select a line of faces with Alt select, they flow along the surface. The same with those here, and also the ones at the top. They are all quads, and quads are easy to subdivide, so that in theory you could subdivide a million times and the super small quads would still flow like this. If I now put trees in here, this edge flow gets broken. You can still select some rows, but this one is interrupted. It is not easy to subdivide because subdivision happens through dividing by 4. But how to divide a tree by 4 without getting fractions? But if we now merge those faces again to form a quad, ta-da! The edge flow is re-established. Sometimes, of course, and especially in 3D printing, you can get away with trees, and also in small corners you can sometimes hide a tree or two. But for the modeling process, quads are best. Okay, enough of this for now. The ring looks dandy and we can continue with the top. Same principle applies here though. We can choose how to put the faces on top. Start with pulling out two vertices towards the center. We could then fill in these two pie slices. Sometimes it is just more comfortable to have a bit more geometry to work with, so I fill them in like this. If there are already faces surrounding the vertices, you can hit Ctrl left click and Blender will try to find the vertices that would form a face. And sometimes this happens. This is mostly because of duplicate vertices. To solve this quickly without having to search for them, select all with A, hit space and search for merge by distance and click it or hit enter. And now would be the right time to create a save file with all the mods still unapplied. This was the creation of the basic signet ring. It is already fully printable. Just export as an STL and check apply modifiers. If you want to dive even deeper into the creation of jewelry and signet rings, decorate them with all kinds of intricate designs, and also get loads of freebies like all the blend files and a helpful community with direct feedback from me, simply check out my Skillshare class. You will also get 14 days of free trial, so you can try it out. Link is in the description. Thanks so much for watching, and see you in my next video!